welcome back to number three on the upgrade process. Where we left is that we've put the whole grinder together. Nothing has been tightened. These four have been backed off one turn from tight, so there's approximately equal gap here between the burr and the plate. These started up. Now we're ready to do our final work. Now, besides this fancy stand, which you're now done with, this is a ball that we got from McMaster's car. It's a 10 millimeter, it's an M10 1.5 pitch thread ball. You can do this by holding on to the thread here, but the ball makes it just, I don't know, costs a buck and a half or something like that, plus shipping. They actually sell it at most hardware stores. You can buy a ball. This is what we use. We use the assembly ball, the magic ball. Okay. Before I start, I check. These are not tight. These are all tight.
So okay. Burr bolts are tight, assembly bolts
are
loose.
These are tight with no wiggling, and these are tight. That indicates that they're all approximately the same tension on that spring, okay, on the burr spring that you saw inside of there. And, you know, by the way, these are like trade secrets that you're learning now.
That's right.
6-7 years worth of this that I've kept this a secret, but you get to hear this for the first time. Okay, so what I'm going to do is our top point here is fixed. This bushing is fixed. Everything else gets aligned in relation to that bushing. So we bring everything into play. Turn it on its side. I loosen the split collar and check. This should have very free movement. Basically, this is checking for the position of this bottom bushing. We want to make sure it's nice and smooth. If it's tight, I can make it tight. But if it binds or it's tight, but you just make sure this is nice and free movement on the axle. So now we have the top bushing and the lower bushing are centric to each other because everything is nice and smooth. So, set it up. Now, we'll take this and we'll tighten this down until it stops. No movement, okay? And we'll turn it about a quarter of a turn. See the movement? Okay, another view here. See that movement?
Just a little, yep.
It's a little less than a millimeter, okay? A little less than a 16th of an inch. Now, we'll with that movement, we tighten, of which this was not pre-tightened, so I got to rip it all the way down. Tighten the nut there. Tighten the bolt on the car.
At a quarter turn?
At one quarter turn. So what I've done is I've created a fairly big gap, not huge. Now is where the scale part comes in. You turn it with your hand. And you look, you listen, and you feel, and you kind of do the safe cracker thing. And in this case, there's one spot that I can feel is a little tight, right there. Don't pay attention to the pointer so much because it doesn't have anything to do with anything. It's a little bindy right there. So I leave it at the bindy spot. What has happened here is that now what you're doing is this burr is in a fixed position and you're gonna move this burr around to align. What happens is that the cone burr is a little off to one side. So I'm gonna use the cone burr as a tool to push the ring burr into position in that bind spot. I find the tight spot and using the knob, I hit it, which made it worse. Once again, you just feel, listen, most of it's feel. Okay, it's not touching anywhere. It's not rubbing anywhere now. It feels great. It's really smooth. Okay, from bashing it with the hammer. Okay, now, I come in with my, I loosen this, and I go a little closer.
So now you're making the gap smaller.
I'm making the gap smaller. The gap is right now about 0.2 millimeters. See? See that movement? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I do the same thing. I listen, I feel. There's a tight spot there. Got rid of it with the hammer. Now I come back in here again, and you can do this like forever. I go a little closer. And you notice how I'm picking it up and sitting it down, like, you know, so I don't change anything. Okay, now I've got a loose spot there and a tight spot over here. Now what you do is you begin to ask the question, can I make it better? Can I make it better? So now I'm going to physically move that ring burr.
Do this by small taps.
This might be a big hammer, but I'm not hitting it too hard. I'm steadying it here to make sure what's moving is the burr. Ooh, that made it nice. And as you go closer and closer and closer, you're able to turn this with no touch of the burr. Sooner or later, you reach the point where it just touches all the way around, and you can't sense this operation. Now I've got it. So I said you can just continue to do this until you either lose your mind.
Loosen.
I loosen
it. Make it a little tighter.
A little tighter. Make sure I don't turn it.
Tighten it up.
Tighten
the adjustment collar again.
I got a spot. It's going. It's like a whisper right in that spot. You can also, where's my light? You can also put a light under it. You can put your phone flashlight in this platform, and you can look at it. And the phone happens to be across the, in your hand.
Yeah, I'm using the phone, sorry.
Yeah, but you can actually look at the light, and you can see if the cone burr, if the gap between the ring and the cone, if the gap moves, if it gets smaller and bigger, if the gap is completely uniform and stationary, doesn't wobble, doesn't move around, you're pretty much done at this point. So I'm going to say, can I make it a little better? That didn't make it better. I do this by, I mean, I built a lot of these things, but I just do this by intuition and feel. If you reach a point where you go down the rabbit hole and you literally start thinking too much, you try to out-engineer this thing, you get kind of sort of defeated, so you might have to start over. You might do like I just did. I shouldn't have started doing this, but I wanted you to see how I did it. There's my tight spot right there. And once, and then, you know, you'll think, it's just, then all of a sudden, it just goes just so clear, it goes so smooth, it doesn't touch anywhere, and you realize that you've done this, like, impossible thing. At this point, I'm so close, there it is, right there, right there, right there. Okay. Once I reach the point that I'm completely satisfied, that it's centered, it's not touching anywhere, it feels good, you check with the light, it looks good, I am done. And when I'm done, I take these, and I tighten them down pretty much finger tight so they hold the setting in place.
You're tightening the burr bolts now.
And remember, you don't need a wrench below because of that deft machining on that carrier. Okay, so I come in with my burr bolts. Now, in the factory, this is a bicycle torque wrench. And it is set at 3 Newton meters, 3 Nm. This is what we use to set it up professionally, okay? If you've got such a torque wrench, these are set at 3 Nm, okay? You don't necessarily need a torque wrench to do it because you reach a point where the mechanism is so tight, you're metal against metal against metal, all these surfaces are against each other, So you could do this with a regular wrench, but you have to do it by feel. You have to say, so it's hard saying what's the bigger skill job, going out and buying a little torque wrench or learning that when they're all the same. If they're
or borrowing a torque wrench from your bicycle buddy.
If they're slightly different, you know, it's not gonna matter because these elements are all squished together so much. So we'll see how I did. This is how we do it in the shop. See, I'm about a quarter of a turn past what I thought was tight. Or a little more. We want to get them approximately the same, but you reach the point, we do it with this heavy torque because we don't want it shifting around, and we like to think that once we've set up the alignment, it's going to stay there forever. Okay, but you tighten them down approximately equal. If you've got a torque wrench, all the best. Now you finger tighten these upside down against the flange. Then this is a 6mm, and I just take it and you just tighten them. These doesn't, at this point, they don't matter if they're the same tightness or not. This is what matters in here. These, you just tighten them so it doesn't come apart. You can use it in any way. You can use any key on this. Okay, those are tight. So now I'm done. Last thing that happens is that this ball comes off, your handle goes back on, your cap goes back on, and here's your cup that will now go in. You now have your Ferris 2.0. You can cover these, you can block these with a little round piece of plastic or tape or whatever, or you can leave it just like it is. The decal, as I said, is a skill job that you center. It's not oriented in any particular way. It just needs to be put on neatly and in the center in relation to these bolts. The one point, that was the 1.1. Where's here? This is the axle that comes with the 1.0. Okay, this is a Imperial. This fits the handle. This is a 1/2 inch fine thread that fits the handle. Then this is the matching split collar that goes with it. That's the only difference. The procedure is just the same. To do 1.0 or 1.1 to
1.0, you may want to, if you still have plastic covers, purchase the metal bolt covers.
Yeah, we've got the metal bolt covers that make it really nice, and the metal bolt covers are all the same length, and the plastic covers, some of them have a little hole in them and they're a different length than the others, and that was before we knew any better, that, you know, we didn't standardize it as well as we should have in those early builds. But now I have a Ferros 2.0, a few basic hand tools. This is, it's nice, but
it's optional, but nice.
It's not critical. This is, as you see, it makes it so you can basically hold it up and bonk it without hitting your thumb with the hammer. But other than that, it's a real simple procedure to make yourself a 2.0 with the upgrade kit. I think I covered everything. I hope I didn't give away too many trade secrets. Barb, did I?
Maybe.
You gonna sue me?
Take it out and trade.
So sue me. Oh, wow. Okay, it's Saturday night in Taichung City, Taiwan. It's been a pleasure showing you how to do this, and thank you very much.